This episode of Amplified is brought to you by Carbonite.
So iPad minis are hot. We have people sending us dashes. The next one we have lined up is for a Subaru STI. So we're gonna get started.
So on the Subi, I like to tape off my line where my iPad's gonna go, and then I grind that line so I can fit the iPad where it needs to be.
No.
So then I like to tape up the mini iPad mock-up that we have and fit it into the dash to where it fits nice, and then I glass the pan from the rear. What the fiberglass does is gives it a nice solid backing so the iPad has a nice cradle to sit in. So to get the overall perfect contour, I like to smash a little bit of Bondo into the corners and then reinsert the iPad into the mold. That way the corners are just perfect and there's little sanding. So this is as far as I got on the Subi today, and we'll pick it back up tomorrow.
This Cadillac came in with a Dubotch factory radio wire taking out the faceplate, and my job today is to fix it. We're gonna show you beginners how to do a deck install.
Or four.
First thing you gotta do is pull the head unit. Then we go to the harness to make sure all of our speakers are working. All the wiring checked out fine, so the problem now lies on that piece of shit factory American made CD player. If you're gonna replace the radio, first and foremost, you gotta look up the parts for the radio, the dash kit, the harness, antenna adapter. Doug starts yapping his lips at me when I tell him to answer the phone because I want to continue working on the Cadillac.
What happened?
Make me mad, dude.
Hey, bro, you're up, bro.
You made me fucking so mad.
No. Oh, sorry, dude.
I just get mad because Rafa, because he's doing a deck install, thinks that he can't do anything else. So he's me. I'm in the bathroom taking a shit, and I hear Rafa, "You're up."
Ooh,
<it's
gone. laughs> There you go.
Sometimes the dash kits can be a bit confusing. They're cheap and it's kind of like putting together a confusing set of Legos.
I put the bottom bracket in, the bottom bracket doesn't beat.
Hey, can you give me a 10 right there? It's a big socket. It's a long one where I was working. The longest one.
That's a socket, you dumbass. Is that a 10, you f***ing dumbass?
You said it was a God, you goofed it, bro. No wonder your government didn't want to beat you,
off. I'm just really getting pissed off. And to top it off, I asked Wishbone for a 10 millimeter socket and he brings me a wrench.
I asked for a socket, bro. That's it. That's all I asked for. A socket.
I guess it's really nice.
The antenna's not even in no more, dude. What the fuck? So mad. It's not funny, guys. It's not funny.
fucking Wishbone. I'm gonna break you off, Wishbone. I'm gonna break your little leg, Wishbone.
Once again, Rafa was being a little bit grumpy, kind of being an asshole as I was helping him install the deck into the caddy. I think somebody needs a grumpy whistle. So when Rafa goes to the bathroom, I lift up his office chair a little bit. That way he has to lower it again when he comes to sit down. I take the air horn and I tape it underneath. That way when he lowers the chair, it's gonna hit the button and it's gonna scare the living shit out of him.
Wishbone. So Wishbone's prank was pretty good. I gotta give it to him. I'm sure he planned it out for hours. But next time he decides to f*** with me, I'm gonna f***ing uppercut his little taint. That little thing right under his asshole. I'll get him.
So it's day two of the iPad mini in the Subaru, and I had this idea of two little lips on the bottom to where the iPad slid in from the top. On this particular one, you couldn't put the magnets on the top because it would have stuck out of the dash, and cosmetically, I didn't think that was the way to go. And now I just gotta grind him up and make him look good.
Come on, motherfucker. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Macho man.
I gotta put a piece of suede back in. I put the suede in the back when I was making my side pieces. That way when we put the suede in for the final, we had the same width. This particular piece came to us with a silver outer paint scheme with a black middle piece. So we went with that same style and did the silver on the outside, black in the middle, just like factory. So I'm super stoked on how this panel turned out.
Rattle can this, rattle can that. Rattle can your mama with a baseball bat.
So the suede's gotta be the best accent to the panel. It makes the panel actually look good when the iPad is out.
That's pretty tight.
Happy with it.
So now that the Subi panel's done, my next one is a 2011 Jeep Patriot. For this one, we're gonna be doing something a little bit different. This one's gonna be a side slider. So we'll have a little slot and a front bezel that it slides into and actually lines up with the dock connector. First step is to see how the iPad's gonna fit on the dash. On this one, I decided to take the right side of the dash back, the width of the iPad.
That way, when it actually is completed, it's coming out no further than the dash came out from stock. The next step, I like to tape off the iPad, find the center of it, the center of the dash that I'm working on.
That was a sexy f***ing blow, dude.
Everything's balanced out, so that's definitely the toughest part.
You gotta smooth that out.
No, I don't.
Yeah,
I don't have to.
Okay.
You want me to, I don't have to.
But you should. That's gonna leave marks.
Me and Jordan don't always agree on our methods, and that's apparent. But today, we're gonna choose to put our differences aside for the greater good of the install.
Can you say something overly professional? That's what everybody wants.
How's that?
Once the iPad's taped on and centered and I know where it's gonna go, I put a little bit of wax on the back of the iPad and lay glass in from the rear. That way I have like a nice contour of where the iPad's gonna go. This one needed a good size slot and straight backing so the iPad could slide all the way in. So I actually had to do it in two pieces just to make sure we had a good slot going.
It will be thickening.
Move.
Office and do nothing like you do all day.
So this is the style that a lot of people mimic. It slides in, docks in, charges. It's definitely the way to go.
Whether you,
stick a bunch here, or stick a bunch there, stick a bunch everywhere.
So next week, I gotta attach the front and get it body worked in, glassed in, and start my primer and paint.
Makes you loopy, man.
100%. Thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned for some funny outtakes, but for now, a word from our sponsor.
Our sponsor this week is Carbonite. Carbonite is the right way to back up your computer so you don't lose your pictures and your stuff.
Getting files back is easy. Your employees can get them back on their smartphones, iPads, or computers.
For a free trial and 2 free months, use promo code AMPLIFIED.
Promo code AMPLIFIED, Carbonite. We actually use Carbonite. I use it personally. It saved a few Amplified episodes in the past, actually. Yeah. So check it out. And also go to caraudiofeed.com. That's where we troll. So come talk to us, ask us your questions, and chill, and all that fun stuff. See ya.
Amplified is filmed on location at Soundman Car Audio in Santa Clarita, California.
Hey, hey guys, I'm Doug.
Let me just easy on the files. Easy.
Yeah, easy.
All the easy on the easy.
So when he goes to the bathroom,
I'm sorry, let me get to wishbone's height. That pussy.